gents. Martin here again, out on our bushcraft. Day 3, it's my last day tonight, and then I'll go home in the morning with my little foraging expedition. And I've just come across this plant here, which is sea holly. And I believe you can eat the roots of this, so I've dug it up. And it's the roots here that I'm after. There's a few there, so I might get a feed, and I've got a few snails as well. So, but I'm going to take this back. Apparently you're supposed to boil it until it gets soft, and you can peel the bark off it, and then you roast it up after that. Some people use the candy it and sugar. So we'll see how it goes when I get back. We'll give it a go anyway. It's food. So I'm quite chuffed to find that. So it's very sticky, very prickly, as you can see. Lovely looking plant. It's a shame I had to decimate it, but I need the roots for food, so I'm going to try them. And I'll let you know how I get on later on. Right. Having a bit of dinner. Campfire and sea beet again. Well, I've got some roots to try in a little while. I'll show you them when I get them on the go, aren't it? Ready to cook, get them looking at them yet. Just boil this lot up, as you can see. Hope about getting your greens in you. It's day 3, my last day here. And we'll do tonight, obviously, and get picked up in the morning. But it's been an experience. Time to go out and find bits and pieces to eat. I've got some more winkles over there. Some more winkles in here and some snails in that one. So I'll boil them up in a little while as well. And some roots up the sea holly, you can see them. We'll boil them down a bit and then get the skins off and prepare them. So we should have enough to eat tonight. And in the morning, when I get home, I'll have the biggest fry up you've ever seen. But this will keep me going for now. So, cheers everyone. No reason for you to starve altogether if you're out here. You know what you're looking for. Now, I ain't no expert, but I've got a rough idea on a few things that will get me by. If you have had snails, mood lice and stuff, it hasn't poisoned me yet. I had crabs yesterday. Well, didn't seem to be any down there today, so I'm not too bothered anyway about that, because the amount of meat you get off is negligible. Just as easy to pick your way through all those winkles. So a bit of root on that one. And it's nice, it's not a bad flavour actually. The sea beet on the samphire. I think the samphire complements that sea beet a wee bit, but on its own it's a bit better. Oh, and also what I've got in here as well, I forgot. Seaweed. I think that's kelp. That was on the beach. I brought that up and washed it all off. There's some seaweed in here and all. It's all moist away to nothing now, but I think you're going to eat most species of seaweed around a British house. You know, as long as you wash it all up like you should do everything, really. I've washed all this lot. Yeah, it's been boiled, so it should be clean. Or safe anyway. I'm trying to find out if it's not. Yeah, I forgot I had the seaweed in there. Found out I was strolling along the beach. And I suppose when you find little things, you know, you eat, you think, oh yeah, there's something. Just get your morale up a little bit, you know, because you could be sitting here like starving, thinking to yourself, oh, I've got nothing to eat, I've got nothing to eat. But as I say, when you find a little thing, it's a little victory, really. And might not be much. It's good enough short term. Long term might not be viable, but depends. If you want to do it long term, you'd have to start setting traps and catching pigeons and rabbits and things like that, and pheasants. But I'm not here long term, I'm only here for 3 days, like I say, which is nearly over, so I've done all right so far. I haven't had a pigeon or a rabbit, but I haven't really needed it, so Tuesday night. Over route. But if you ride any length of time, you would go up with a proper meat for protein, like. And you got enough vegetables on the go anyway to complement them as well. But at the minute, I'm just managing on the snails and the winkles and stuff. Which is not much, but it's better than nothing. I'm just prepared to eat them. And honestly, why not? I've had them around, don't mean no one. You boil them up first, make sure. And get all the crap out of the dirt in first. Well, that was nice. That's something in my stomach. I've got my little bush boxer down here I'm going to light up shortly. I'm not sure how long my gas is going to last for. So I've got my little bush back just in case of emergencies, and I'm going to light that up and do them roots on it in a minute and see how they go. And I'll get back there when they're all cooked and let you see what they're like. Well, ladies and gents, the roots have been boiled, but what you're supposed to do now, I believe, is peel the bark off and use that white stuff on it. So I'm trying to peel the bark off a lot of this, and then what we'll do is roast it over my little bush box. It should be quite nice. I just had a little taste there, it's not too bad. I'm just going to peel all the outside skin off. It's a source of carbohydrates, isn't it? You know what I mean? So, got a bit of protein with the snails and the winkles and stuff, and I had the sea beaten sandpaper there. So I'm just gonna do these. So we'll parboil them and then skin them and roast them. A lot of work. But don't got anything else to do, so give a minute. Should be out of job, I know that. Try and leave enough on it for the meat on it, like, you see what I mean? Excuse the mechanism. I'll chop all them roots up and put them in a little pot, my little cup here with some sugar, and heat them all up. This is what they come out like. I don't know if you can see any of that in there. Probably can't, but that's what they're like. All sort of candied up, so we'll see what they're like now. Nice sweet flavour then. Consistency of a chestnut. Not too bad. Cheers. Here's me to go home now. This is a fourth day, so I'm on my way home in a minute. Just knocked the camp down and showing you around. This is where I was. And apart from my kit there, what I'm going to take with me in a minute. It's more or less the way I left it. There's no mess, no nothing left here. It all looks the way it was. So I thought it all back. So just let you have a little look. No trace. See you later on, ladies and gents. Over there in that little thicket, there was where I was stopping. I'm on the way out now. Left everything the way it should be. Clear and tidy and the way it was when I found it. Just heading back up the lane. Sorry about the interruption. Lovely Carol phoning me up to tell me she's nearly up here to pick me up. So I'm just heading back out now. So it's been a different 3 days. One thing coming out, camping out, way camping and things when you